You can see this? Okay, okay. Here you can see this my colleagues of this space. We are in Trani, in the south of Puglia. Just a moment, okay. In the south of Puglia, as I can see, and we try to open a space in which design project can have place, starting from the projectation of an object until the creation of a prototype and after the object finished. We open a space in which we show lots of object of design created by artisans that work in the, this part of our country, in our Puglia, and every designer, every object try to tell of our Puglia. In particular, in this case, we tell about a project that is around the technique to work with wood. So now I show you our presentation about this work. Just a moment. Okay. Okay, our work is about is a research about what we can do with a new digital technique of work with wood. For example, we have this kind of clock, this image that is a traditional object, but has a particular design that you can create by hand, yes, but you need lots of time. But in this case, you can use digital technique, like, for example, a CNC machine or a pantographer to obtain this object. This is a traditional object, but with this kind of technique and machinery, you can create also new object with new shapes. For example, you can create a wood tile that has these particular shapes and design that is very difficult to create with this precision by hand. So now you can use a computer aid to design the shapes, the forms, and after you can give to a CNC machine the file to work good and create, for example, this kind of object. So we want to focus our attention about the possibility that you can have now with this technique to work with a traditional object, but very faster, and new possibility of design that you can have now using this machinery and that you can't had in the past, maybe only using traditional tools. What is a CNC machine? I think you know a CNC machine, maybe, but we try to present some particular aspect of this kind of machinery and the technique that is linked to the disuse. The name CNC means computer numerical control. So in the work in this way to the with wood, you have and at the start part total control of the process by the computer using particular software that in general are CAD software, with which you can draw the piece that you want to create, and after you use the machine to cut this kind of piece. Yes, here you can see, for example, our CNC machine that we have in our space, because we have a little space in which we can create some new object, and is a space open also to the collectivity of our country. So also other people can come here and use this machine with us or also alone. You have this is a particular machine. It's not very big, because maybe you know there are CNC machines that are very bigger, some meters of the rectangular plane of work. You can see here the dimension of our machine that are these, so 400 mm and 600 mm. So you can create a piece. Or if it's bigger, the piece of wood you have to create, you piece in more part that after you have to compose to obtain the big piece. This machine has a different kind of tools to move on this rectangular plane. And to cut the piece. Maybe in the photo you can see some track, some path that the machine creates when it work. So you have this part that can move in this direction, okay? These that can move in this direction and up and down, because every CNC machine work on these three axes, x-axis, the other direction, so in horizontal, in vertical, and you have a different kind of height that you can have to cut and work with the machine. So why use a machine, and why can be necessary use this? First of all, you can now obtain complex curved geometries in two dimension or three dimension, like the geometry that I show you before. Is very complex and is difficult to create only by hand. Another possibilities is that with this machine you can have more precision in work, and most important is also that you can repeat the process and obtain more pieces equal starting from the first. So you can have a series of objects, and when you work manually, every piece is always different. Maybe in little components, but is different. And as I say before, is important to improve the production planning and increase the productivity. How CNC machine works. So you have to create the design of the object, first of all, using a CAD software. At the end of the process, you have created a G-code that contain all the information that the machine needs to move on the base and to cut the object, because you have more kind of process that you can have that are or of engraving or of surfaces, or all only to cut a piece with only a line. So in fact, every number of the code is assigned to a particular operation. When I say G-code, you have to think to these kind of sequences of number and letters that you can see in the final part of this slide, okay? And there are a series of coordinates with which the machine moves on the of the rectangular base. So in fact, when is running, part of program is interpreted one command line at a time until a line of completed. Okay. Toolpath, cutting and plotting motion. So these are some of the aspects that you have to consider to work with a CNC machine. So the toolpath is, for example, describes the track, the route that the cutting tool takes and follow during the cut work. So, for example, if in the CAD software you design a line, only a line, after the CNC machine follow this line that you have drawn like a path with which cut the wood. You can also control on the machine the speeds and the rate at which the tool operates. You have to define different speeds linked to the kind of wood you are using, you are cutting, because you have some wood that are hard, very hard, and some wood that are less hard. So the speeds can change linked to the hardness of the wood, because you can break the cutting tool. Okay. Every kind of CNC machine consists of this following part. So you have a program part that are a series of code extraction required to produce the part. As I say you before, we are now speaking about the G code that I presented you before. Controls the movement of the machine tool and the on-off control of auxiliary functions such as the spindle rotation. As I say you before, the code instructions are composed by letters, numbers, and symbols. You have also a machine control unit that is the heart of a CNC machine. It is used to perform the following functions. For example, to read the code instructions, to generate axis motion commands, and to receive the feedback signal of position and speed of each drive axis. What means that, as I show you after, you have a control panel in which you can see the position second by second of the cutting tool on the table work, but you control this on the display of your computer. So you here you can control the speeds, the position, and the depthness of the cutting work. And you have obviously the machine tool, because CNC controls are used to control various type of machine tool. The machine table is, as I said you before, controlled in the three different kind of axis and direction. Okay, the general workflow to go from CAD model to machined CNC part is: begin with a CAD model, okay? Establish the job parameter including CNC coordinate system and stock shape size. Select the CNC process, select the cutting tool and the machining parameters, select the driving CAD geometry. Verify the toolpath, and after I show you a video in which all these phases you see directly in a video. I think it's very directly to understand. Okay. So, for example, we now present you two kind of project that we create here in our space using the CNC machine that I showed you before. These two projects of design original are Texity and Puglisi. Showing these two new design projects, I try to explain better the use of the CNC machine to create a new design object. Okay. Texity is an olive wood tile with maps on the upper part of some representative cities of Puglia, created and designed by me and my colleagues. Puglisi is another project created by the architect Angelo Ricciuto, and is a round wall lamp that represents the arts and the craft of the Apulian tradition works. This is an example of a design object created by us. This is Texity, is a wooden tile in olive. And these kind of drawings that you can see here are the outline of the building of some cities of Puglia. Okay, it's clear? Okay, and how we create this this style, starting from a drawing of this part of the city. After the CNC machine with the cutting tool creates the holes, the engraving following this line that are the limits of the buildings, and in the second time we put a particular material that I explain you after in this hole created by the machine. Texity involve a review and updating of a traditional wood inlay processing technique through the use of a current available technologies. The numerical control machinery such as pantograph machine, in fact, allows the maximum precision cutting and engraving of wooden surfaces. As I said you before, the contours of the city plan are obtained by CNC numerical control milling or the laser cut machine of the visible face of the tile for a depth equal to the half of its thickness. The incisions are filled to their full depth by a mixture variously pigmented. A mixture is of resin and fine-grained aggregates. I'm speaking about this part, okay? That is similar in the aspect to the stone. Deriving from the wood processing waste itself until it has a perfect complementarity with the visible face of the tile. The procedure therefore avoids the production of processing waste and makes the creation of the tile an eco-compatible process because this part is what remain, is the dust that remain with the cutting process. So we reuse this dust with a particular color and to put it in these holes and obtain these shapes, this form that are the building of the cities, because this represents the map of the historical part of some typical cities of Puglia. Here you can see the process. So starting from a squared tile of olive wood, with the machine tool you create all these holes in the tile, and in the second time the mixture of resin inert and the dust of that obtained with the cutting process is reused to put it in these holes and obtain the shapes of the cities. In green, you can see some particular part of the old part of the city that are monuments or churches or, for example, historical palaces. In fact, the Texity tile processing phases are similar to the classic wood marquetry method, except for the replacement of the tool used. In fact, you need of a careful preliminary design phase of drawing, and this phase is fundamental. In the past, the drawings were transferred directly to the wooden top using carbon paper starting from preparatory draft. While at present, this phase can be managed through CAD software, as I said you before, for the definition of the path of the track that the machinery cutting tool must follow. So, in the, as you can see, in the past, you have to drawing by hand the geometry of the decoration or the piece that you have to create. And manually, you have to use particular tools like this that you can see to carve the surface of wood with different kind of angulation of now the difference is that you can use a machine, but the mental process of the drawing of the project is the same. These are some typical ancient tools that we used to create different kind of excavation. So, every excavation is linked to the shape of the tool. So you have this that is bigger, this is smaller, they are all linked. Now, if in the past you have to drawing by hand this geometry directly on the surface of the wood piece, now you can program your drawing on a CAD software like this. This is a screen of the display. So you have to drawing the outline of the building like line object, and after the machine read the every single object, every single line, every single point, like a road, like a stroke to follow with the cutting process. After you have to use a CAM software, that means computer-aided manufacturing. So in the phase in which you are drawing the object, you use a CAD software. In the second phase, when you have to create and cut the object, you use another software, a CAM software, that means computer-aided manufacturing, to transform the drawings into work path for the CNC machine. In this phase, it is necessary to define the type of processing to be performed. So, for example, if you have this thickness of the wooden panel, you can have a full thickness cutting or only a part, for example, a partial thickness excavation of this area. And this area is defined by the drawings that you can see here in yellow or in red. Or another kind of processing is engraving on the surface with a defined depth, or for example, drilling in some point. In the reality, you have more and more typology of cutting processing. Here we try to resume the most common process that you can use. And for every kind of processing, you have to choose a particular cutting tool to be mounted on the end of the spindle, which generates a particular cutting profile. I can try to say, in the past, you have this. It's clear that you have to use this manually. and you have this different kind of engraving linked to the shape of the tool. Now it's the same, but every one of these different kind of tool you have to put on the machine, and you have different kind of engraving linked to the shape of this tool, because you have these, for example, in blue that are flat, or these that are rounded, or these that are, for example, to cut other kind of material when the wood is very hard. And you have also this other kind of tools, because with this you have a linear cutting, okay? With this you can have a shaped cutting of the panel linked to this kind of profile. It's an example of what you can have. As I say you before, in the CAM process, this is an interface of the program, of the software. You have to define, for example, the shape of the tool, the diameter, the dimension, all the characteristic of the cutting tool that you have chosen to cut the wood. For example, this can be rounded, or can be flat, or can have a V section. For example, you have to give to the machine information about the dimension of the wood pieces. Wood pieces that you have to cut, and you have to choose the same point of origin in the software and in the reality of the wood pieces that you have to cut. So, for example, this point on the software in the reality has to be this, because the machine have to recognize the same origin point. You have to fix the panel of wood to cut on the machine, because it can move. And this is an interface of the display of the machine, of CNC machine, in which you can find the G-code that I showed you before, the first part, and you have all the coordinates of the cutting tool during the movement that it do. Here you can see the movement or the cutting tool following all this kind of line. Now we start with a little video in which all these things that I show you before, you can see with the video. And we use this video to present you the other project that I showed you before, that was named Puglisi, and that is a wall lamp. Just a moment. Okay. So in this part, the first phase is, for example, to create an excavation on the panel. At the end, you see the final object created, and you understand, because you have to do first this kind of process of cutting. So in this case, you have to create this engraving on the surface of this particular shape. And the second time, you have to cut around the shape. for example. At the, in the third phase, you have the full depth cutting of the external shapes to separate the lamp from the initial pieces. At the end, you obtain this kind of object. I hope that with this video and this final image, it's more clear the process of the creation of this wooden lamp. In these two images, you can see the particular of the work created, because these are little particular like sunglasses, the flower, cutted on the different kind of wood essence. Because are detail that we like to put in evidence in contrast with the white part of the lamp. In fact, as you can see in the wooden panel is an MDF wood panel that after is painted in white. And in the final part, we had this kind of lights. Maybe if you can see in the video, I have here one that I can show you live. Just a moment. Okay. For example, this is another.
Is that you in the picture?
I'm here.
Is that you in the picture?
No, I'm not. I'm not. Okay. This is a host.
Okay.
The project tried to put in evidence and to celebrate some of Apulian typical jobs. So you have, in this case, the florist, but you have the fisherman, the farmer, this is the host. We have many kind of jobs that are representative of our land. I have finished with my presentation. I don't know if Laura has to give other information, but if I have the time, I try to show you a little video about our reality.
Yes, thank you. And right after this video, I would like to ask or encourage participants to ask all the questions about these presentations, if you have any.
Okay. Just a moment.
J'avais jamais vu des nuits aussi claires. Je regarde enchaîner les cigares. C'est une colonne sans son entre toujours ici. On se glisse comme un avec zéro. On campe sur cette terre. Je pourrais te faire le cri de l'enfer. On ne sait pas détenir longtemps. Tu m'as même comparé à Lucifer. Non, mais j'hallucine. Je sais déjà ce que la distance entraîne. Soit c'est la guerre pendant 10 ans sans trêve. Soit je la quitte en 8 ans.
Okay, this is to present all the objects that we can create here. Maybe, as you can see, we try to create a network between all the designers that marry our job.
Maybe you can tell us more about this tomorrow when we...
Okay.
The inclusion. So, do you have any question for Giuseppe?
Yes, I think I would like to ask something.
Okay.
Giuseppe, so I know that you are an architect, and well, in Finland, actually in Northern Europe and in Scandinavia, we have this trend of building houses from wood, and there's a rebirth of this trend. And for example, in Stockholm, in Sweden, 2023, there will be 100 meters high skyscraper that's made of wood. So it's a developing industry in this part of the world. So do you have this kind of trend also in the Mediterranean countries?
Here we have maybe a different kind of trend, but because we have maybe a different kind of tradition of construction, because in the south of Europe, and in particular, for example, in the Mediterranean part, we have a traditional of construction with stone, for example. In fact, all the our ancient parts of the cities are built in stone. So the aspect of the cities is very characterized by this material. And this also the motive because we think that we thought about the Texity project, in which the wood is mixed to the stone to represent the building of the city. This is true, but it's also true that we have more experiences of skyscrapers building on the new on about all the buildings that are not of restoration works. If I think about Milano, we have the last experiences in which we have these big skyscrapers, very high, even if the wood it's not maybe the material selected to this kind of building. Maybe it's a mixture between steel and concrete stone.
Do you think it's because of the climate, that the climate we have in the Mediterranean areas, that we don't prefer wood?
Yes, I think it can be one of the possibility, even if we think about the history in the past, stone buildings can create a better weather in the indoor of the houses, because in this way you can protect you from the cold in the winter, and with the hot in the summer, because with stone you have a different kind of process in with which the hot enters in the house, because it's postponed in the time, you know, because you have the action of the weight material that you have maybe is if in the morning you have very hot with the stone, in the night maybe in the indoor you have the hot, but that is necessary, and the contrary.
Thank you. Are there any other questions?
Well, I would have a question as well. First of all, Giuseppe, thank you for the presentation, because it was really clear.
Not very clear.
Sorry, Giuseppe, could you stop sharing your screen?
Sorry?
Could you stop sharing so we can see the participant?
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
I have to share?
No, stop sharing.
Okay.
Great.
Sorry.
Okay, so you spoke during the presentation about two softwares, the CAD software and the CAM software. So first of all, I wanted to know if they are free online. And the second question is, how much time do you think users need to learn to use these two softwares?
Okay, I start from the first. Are not free software, even if you can try, you can find some light version of this software. When I say light, I want to say that are not the complete software. Okay, so it's possible that some functions are not available. Okay, but very often you find some trial version that can be good to start to learn to using the program. Okay. As Taina said before, we are architects, so we start to using this software when we are child. No, I'm joking. No. So I'm joking. When we start our studies to become an architect, so at university, for example, I use this kind of program. I think from 10 years, but. To learn, you need not need all this time. If you start to use this software every day, in some weeks you can have the first knowledge to use this, because with the CAD file you have only to. Drawing, define the lines, the point, the shapes, the outline of the object. Okay. After you have to know the process with the CAM file, in which you have to say to the machine, okay, I draw this line 1 meter, 10 centimeter in CAD file. But this line correspond to a CAD tool that is depth how many millimeter, for example. These are the answer that machine ask you, okay? And you have to define, okay, this track of 10 centimeter has to have the depth of 3 mm, for example. Or with the tool that has a finished carved shape or flat shape. These are the processes. Okay, and I think for us to give a real experience, we are in this space and we have this machine until 2 years. Okay, now I'm able to use the machine well, but I have lots of things to learn. But to a simple use of the machine in some weeks, a month, you can learn.
Thank you. So we approach the end of this first session today. If there aren't any other questions, I would like to share with you a link of an evaluation questionnaire, and I would like you to complete it now, maybe in the last few remaining minutes. Tomorrow and the day after, we will start straight away with sessions conducted by our partners, because today we presented ourselves and the training. So, if there isn't anything else you would like to ask or discuss, I would kindly ask you to complete the questionnaires I shared with you, and see you tomorrow at the same time. So, can we do it now while we are connected? I think we should have 26 questioners because we were 26 participants. So, I leave you a few minutes to complete the questionnaires and then we can say bye to each other. So done. It's a very short one.
Okay, I have answer to the question.
Okay, so thank you very much for your presence today and see you tomorrow at the same time.
See you.
See you tomorrow.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow.
Bye.